Hello 11th class, this is your chapter 6 introduction of Python and lecture number 3. So in the previous class we learned what is Python and what are its feature, advantage, disadvantage. Okay, so in this class you will learn some more fundamentals of Python. So here now we are going to start the programming. So before going to start the programming, we have to learn some important terms, okay? So first we need to understand that what is a program. A program is a group of instructions which controls processing, okay? Means the base for processing is the program. So in this chapter, we will just come to know about various elements of processing like character set, token, expression, statements, input, okay? But here in this class I have included only character set and tokens. Okay, so next is Python character set. What is character set? The character set is a group of letters or signs which are specific to a language. So in this, character set includes letter, sign, number and symbol. So in letters, we include the capital letter and small letter. Then in digits 0 to 9. In special symbol, we include underscore, plus, minus, multiply. Okay, so these are the special symbol. In white spaces, we include blank space, tab, carriage return, new line, form field, etc. Okay, and in other characters, we include the ASCII characters and the Unicode characters. Okay, so these are the character set of Python. Next is, what is token? So token is any small individual unit in Python is called token. Okay, whatever the text or the individual words or punctuation marks are there, it is called token. So in token we have the following things, that is keyword, identifiers, literals, operators and punctuator. So in this class I have covered keywords, identifier and literals. Okay, so what are keywords? Keywords are those words which provides a special meaning to interpreter. Okay, you cannot change the letter, means if any keyword is in capital letter, then you have to write it in capital letter. If any keyword is in small letter, then you have to write it in small letter only. Because as you know, Python is a case sensitive language. And we also call that keywords are reserved words that have some specific meaning. Okay. Keywords cannot be used as identifiers, variable name or any other purpose. Keywords are fixed. It has a special meaning. Okay, so these are some available keywords in Python. So these are the keywords, you just go through with it. Okay, now next is identifier. So identifier is also very important. You have to know that how to write the any identifier. Okay, even in board exam there is a question that you have to identify the valid and the invalid identifier. So identifier are the building blocks of a program that are used to give names to different parts on the block of program, like variable, object, classes and functions. Identifier may be a combination of letters and numbers. So while writing any identifier name, you can use the letters and numbers. An identifier must begin with an alphabet or an underscore. Okay, identifier can be begin with an alphabet or underscore. Subsequent letters may be numbers 0 to 9, okay, and a letter can be followed by any character number also. Okay, Python is case sensitive. Uppercase character are distinct from the lowercase character. Okay, length of an identifier is unlimited. You can write, okay, any length of the identifier. Keywords cannot be used as an identifier. Keyword as an identifier. Space and special symbols are not permitted in an identifier name except an underscore sign. Okay, except in the special symbol underscore, you cannot use any special symbols. Okay, like plus, minus, big bracket, small bracket, etc. You cannot use the special symbol. So here is some example of some valid identifier. These are my file. In this my file, am is capital. This is valid. Now date 9_7_17. Okay, so you can use underscore or you can use digit but followed by any letter. Next is Z2T0Z9. This is also valid. You can use digits but that digit is followed by the letter. Now underscore can be come at first. In this this one also underscore can use here. Okay, so this is also valid. So some invalid identifier are, this is data. In between data I record, I have used here hyphen. So this is wrong. This 29 color, here I have used 29 digits at the first. This break, this is a keyword. Now my dot file, I am using here dot, that's why it is invalid. Okay, so you have to learn that what is identifier, what are its rules. Next is literals or values. So literal are often called the constant value, means literals are fixed. So Python permits the following type of literal. So these are the types of literal, that is first one is string literal, Pankaj. Numeric literal, you can write in this way. Boolean literals, in this true or false will come. There is a special literal, that is none. Okay, so we will discuss each by one by one. First one is a string literal. So string literal, that is a collection of characters enclosed in the double or the single quote. Okay, while writing the string literal, you can use the single or the double. Okay, both way are the valid. So here you can see this Python. This is the opening and the closing quotes. So it is valid. This one is also valid. In this, I have used here at the down single quote. That's why it is invalid. This one is also invalid. Here this dollar symbol invalid. This 4 is invalid. This at the rate is valid. Okay. So in Python, both single character or multiple character enclosed in quotes such as this are treated as the same. Okay. So next is string type in Python. So Python allows you to have the two string type, that is single line string and the multi-line string. So here is the single line string. In this, the string we create using single or the double quotes are normally single line string. That is, they must terminate in one line. Okay, this is single line string. So here, for example, if you write this double quote then KV and you forgot to write the closing quote and then press enter, so Python will give you the error, that is end of line, while scanning the string literal. Okay, so the reason is clear, because you have not closed the double quote. Okay, so this is single line string. The multi-line string. So multi-line string means when you are writing the multiple line in the string. So for storing the multi-line string, you have two ways. That is, first one is by adding a backslash at the end of the normal single or the double. That is, this name is equal to inverted comma 1/6 Mall Road slash and then Kanpur. Okay. So here I am using the multi-line string by adding this slash. So when you put the slash and press the enter, then this will come in the last and then close the double quote. And when you print the name, then it will not show any space here in between the road and the Kanpur. Okay, it will just come in single line without any space. So in multi-line string, this one is the second one. Here by typing text in triple quotation mark. So here if you write the thing in the triple quotation mark, this will also take it in as a multi-line string. Okay, in triple quote. So here print address. Now if you press here before New Delhi, here enter key. So this text will come in the next line and then close this quote. And the when you print this print address, so it will show you the thing in a single line. Okay, and if you print the address, then this slash n is here after this Preet Vihar, then it will show you the slash n also, that is the means new line. Okay, you have pressed the enter key in this single multiple line by using the triple quote. Okay, I'll show you I'll show you it practically. Okay, on Python IDLE. So next is size of string. How will you calculate the size of the string? Okay, you just see for in a string you have to count the characters of the string. For example, the string is XYZ. So what is the size? It says how many characters are there XYZ in XYZ? That is 3. So and in welcome it is 7. But if your string literal has an escape sequence contained in it, then make sure to count the escape sequence as one character. I will also discuss the escape sequences, okay, at the end of this class. Okay, so this string, this is the backslash and this is the supporting backslash, so its size is 1. So here this is the opening, okay, ABC, so it will show you 3. This slash AB, it will show you 2. Now Mira's toy, it will show you 11. So Vicky's, it will show you 7. Okay, you can check the size by using this len function. Okay, for example, len, then ABC and press enter key. So it will show you the size as 3. Okay, this single quote is also correct. So do not get confused. Now next is for multiple line string. So when you use this triple quote, okay, then the end of line is also encountered, means the slash n. So it will also calculate the slash n as a enter key. It will also be calculated. So when you calculate the length of this, so it will show you 18. Okay, for multiple string created with the single quote or the double quote, okay, by the slash. So it will not count the slash, it will just count the string only. Okay, so this is multiple string with created by the single quote, single or the double quote, okay, by slash. So it will not calculate the this slash symbol. But in multi-line string, if you are using this triple quote, then you have, then it will calculate your end of line character also. Next is numeric literal. So in numeric literal, it also has some type. The first one is an integer literal. So integer, it contain at least one digit and must not contain the decimal point. It just contain the natural number only. It will not include any floating point number. The decimal point, decimal numbers, okay, this is the floating point number. So in type of integer, that is the decimal. In decimal, the range is 0 to 9. Octal, it starts from the symbol O, then 0. Okay, so it is octal, its range is 0 to 7. And its base is 8, that represents decimal 8. Okay, its base is also 8, octal. Next is, if you will print this O, 0, 1, 0, this is 0010, then it will give you the answer 8. Now hexadecimal, it starts from 0x, so here 0x will come in num equal to 0x. Okay, after this 0, x will also come, so num, it will print the value 0. No, here this f represent the 15 in hexadecimal. Okay, that's why it show you 15 value. Next is second point. The first one is the integer one. Second is the floating point literal. So this is also known as the real literal. So real literal are the numbers having the fractional part. In floating point number, you have the fractional part. Okay, if the number is in fractional form, that only then we call it floating point number. It is represented in the two form, that is fractional form or the exponent form. What is fractional form? So when you are writing any number in the decimal point, then it is a fractional form. Okay, exponent form. So exponent has the two part, that is mantissa and exponent. For example, the 10.5, you can represent it as 0.105. Okay, so this 10 is placed by two digits so that the power of 10 is 2. So here in this way you can write, so this 0105 is the mantissa. and this 0 2 is the exponent. Okay, after letter this e, it is called the exponent. Next is Boolean letter. So Boolean always give you either true or false. Okay, only these two value will come. For example, if you are writing here, is married equal to true, and then you are checking the type. Okay, this type is also a keyword. So when you are typing, type is married, the what is the type of this is married, so it will give you the result class is Boolean. Okay, it will give you the Boolean literal. By this way you can check whether it is a Boolean literal or not. Okay, next is special literal none. So this special literal none, it will show you nothing, means that particular variable does not contain anything. Okay, in other languages it is known as the null, and it is also used to indicate the end of the list in Python. So here salary equal to none and type salary, when I am checking the type of this, so it will give you the none type. Okay, so this is also a special literal none. Now complex number. So complex number is new for you. The complex number is made of the two floating point values, one each for real and the imaginary part. Okay, for accessing different parts of the variable x, we will use x dot real and x dot imaginary. Okay, for example, in this x is 1 plus me 0 j, so this 1 is the real part and this 0 is the floating point value, this is the imaginary part. So if you want to print the value, then you have to write the print x dot real, it will give you 1.0, it will give you floating point number. Okay, because the both the real and the imaginary part will give you the floating point number. Now x dot imaginary, it will give you 0.0. okay, this is the second example. Now next is the escape characters. So escape character, they are the special character which cannot be typed directly from the keyboard, like the backspace, tab and enter key. So these are the special character. When the characters are typed, they perform some action. As you know, when you press the backspace key, so it will delete the particular character. Tab means when you press the tab key, so it will give you some space. So these are represented by the escape characters. Escape characters are always begin from the backslash character. Okay, so here is a list of the escape character. So these are the list of the escape sequence. So when you use this double slash, so it will give you single slash. Okay, this backslash, when you want to use a single quote, then you have to use the backslash, then single quote, then double quote. Okay, this way, this is the ASCII bell. When you press slash A, it will give you a sound of bell. Okay, now these highlighted one, this is the new line and this is the tab. These two you use regularly in your programs. Okay, so these two are the important one. This slash N is for the new line and this slash T is for the horizontal tab. Okay, so now I am going to show you the Python IDLE. Okay, so you have to write here Python So in this, I will show you that how to write the string literal. For example, I am writing here a equal to inverted comma hello. Okay, and now you are printing print a. So it will give you hello. Okay, now the comments. Okay, single line comment and double line comment. When you want to add some character, for example, I am writing here hi. Okay, and then slash hello. Okay, now this triple quote will come, it means the this single line, this multiple line comment will end here, and now you want to print here, so it will give you hi hello. And if you are using the with print a, so it will give you the same. Okay, so when you write with a only, so it will give you the result as a string. This single quote show you the string, and when you write it in the print, then it will give you the variable a contain. What a variable a contain? It contain the hi hello. Okay, so this is the single line comment with backslash. And if I am writing here a, suppose b is equal to triple quotes. So 1, 2, 3. Hi, then hello. Okay, 1, 2, 3. Now I am printing this. So it will give you hi then slash n, because after hi I have used the enter key. Okay, and if you want to write it in the print statement, then it will show you hi, hello. Okay, so when you are using it with variable b, then it will show you the complete way that how you are writing the string. Okay, and when you are using the print b, so it will show you the variable b, what a variable b contains. Okay, so if you want to calculate the length of b, so it will give you 8. Okay, now length of a, that is 7. Okay, so this way you can check you. Okay, so for example, I am writing equal to a is equal to true. Okay, now you want to check the type. So here type a, it will give you class boolean. By this way you can also check that what the class of the variable a. Now you can see here the value of a is earlier is hi hello, and now the value of a has changed. I am writing it a boolean literal, that is true, that's why it show give you the result boolean. Okay, so by this way you can check by your own. This is very simple. So I hope these things are clear to you. Okay, so your homework is, again you have to see the video again and make notes. Okay, and if you have any doubt you can ask. So for this class, this is done. So thank you and have a nice day.